For our first story, we didn't stray too far from home. Flea markets can be quite the treasure trove for penny pinchers. And while you might think a bargain's a bargain, we found a couple of flea market experts who claim some method to their madness. Producers Susan Grissom and Luther Bradfute gave them 50 bucks and followed them to the Memphis flea market for a few tips.
Hi, I'm Ron.
And I'm Bethany.
And we're at the Memphis flea market, and we're going to see if we can take this $50 inside and find some bargains that we can turn around and resell for profit.
It's fun to do, especially if you know what you're doing. But if you don't know what you're doing, that's fine too, because it's even more fun. We're going to give you tips and techniques on how to do that.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, let's go.
These are some rules that I've developed over the years that might help you find some cool and potentially valuable things when you're shopping at a flea market. One, know as much as possible about as much as possible. You don't have to know everything, but if you know more than the person that's selling you the item, then you're more likely to get a good deal.
I mean, honestly, you could make something really cool out of that. Just frame it. So, that's a mustard seed.
Two, just because it's old doesn't mean it's valuable.
This is a vintage Christmas card of cats playing pool.
Do you know, like, maybe when you've had, how old is that?
Date from like the 50s.
Three, if you're buying something for resale, be sure you know that there are other people who want it and what they tend to pay for it. You might not find a buyer, and if you don't find a buyer, that means you have to keep it.
$5 American.
Things are fairly priced sometimes, and you may want them, but you can't make money off something that's fairly priced, because if it's worth $12 and you paid $12 for it, where's the profit?
Four, become an expert at one thing, preferably something you're interested in. It makes it more fun, and then if you don't sell it, you can keep it and add it to your collection.
That's pretty awesome. This is a 1970 Ole Miss football schedule token or medal. The 5 I owe you, 18.
Oh. Oh, really?
Yeah. Just barbecue bologna and water.
Can I give it to you? It still works.
A big hunk of fried bologna.
You know what it needs?
What?
Cheese. We need cheese.
Five, look for the unusual. Once you've been doing this for a while, you'll have a gut feeling about some items. If you've been bargain hunting for years and you've never seen something like it, that might be a good sign that it's rare. If it's cheap, go ahead and grab it and research it later.
But this is from the 1780s. I got something great.
Just got what's called an encased coin. They're kind of little good luck charms, but they're used for advertising. Also, the side with the penny on it, it's a 1956 penny, and it's got like a wishbone and a horseshoe and a four-leaf clover. But on the back, it advertises Darden Smith Jewelry Company at 110 Madison Avenue, Memphis.
I found something. I think it's cool. It's a book, but it's got a piano inside. What's really cool about that is that there's a lot of reasons somebody might want to collect that, but I'm debating on this and a monkey blotter. This is a blotter, an old blotter. It's for your desk. It says don't monkey with anything on this desk. It's got Memphis, Tennessee on it. If there's one thing that people like collecting, it's monkeys. What'd you get?
Well, I don't 100% know what it is, and I think it's from Austria. It's possibly was used in a part of Austria that was, I don't know what it is, I'm gonna look it up. But it's big and purple.
Yeah. You know, there's more beta carotene in this one chew than in a carrot.
Thank you very much, appreciate it. The good thing about things in foreign languages is a lot of people are lazy and they don't bother trying to figure out what things actually are. Yeah, I found things in a 3 for $1 bin before I've sold for $250 on eBay. Oh, that's a wicked smell.
Wonderful, man. Aren't they good?
This one is the Naval Air Station Memphis, which of course doesn't exist anymore.
What about this stuff? Like I said, I don't know what that is, but to me it's cool.
find a lot of cool things for our $50. And while I'm not quite sure what they're going to sell for, that brings us to our most important rule, which is rule number 6. Don't forget to have fun. Most of all, the flea market is as much about the experience as it is the bargain. Don't forget to experience all the sights, the sounds, the smells, and yes, even the tastes of the flea market.
And it is the coolest, funnest place to be at.
So excited about this walk. Should I tell them that I got some piercings back?